Okay, ah. No, first afternoon a bit sleepy. Question 10. Go to question 10, ah. Question 10, okay. Question 10 got some value lah, huh? Got some value. So I'll go through. Okay, ah. Part 1 is okay. Do I need to go through? Part 1 no need, ah. Okay, I go through part 2. Verify that the point lies on plane 1. This one is okay, ah. This one should be okay. Find the perpendicular distance from point to plane 2. So you observe. Okay, I just borrow your classmate's solution. Okay, ah. Okay, ah. So first one, this one done. Okay, let me see, ah. Okay, okay, good, there's a question, there's a diagram here. Okay, ah. What they are asking for is the perpendicular distance from P to plane 2. So if I go to this question, okay, ah, you can see that, okay, again, on the top right hand corner, we always try to use a diagram lah. Okay, oh. Actually, I use a lot of diagram for this question. Maybe you all have always try to use diagram. Okay, ah. So plane O, there's a plane, okay, ah. P to the plane 2. Okay, so this is what it means. Oh. This is that plane 2. Okay, to do that, in order to do that, we want to find, what do you want to find? We want to find the perpendicular distance, okay, from point to plane 2. Perpendicular distance from point is basically we are looking for this lah. We are looking for this. Okay? Can huh? Okay, huh? So looking hard at this diagram, okay, doesn't matter whether it's OP or PO. You want to use you can use OP, that's fine. Okay, OP is basically your 7, 2, negative 1. Along the end, the direction vector is 3, 1, 2. This is the normal of plane 2. This is the normal of plane 2. Okay, because your plane 2 equation, remember, is R dot 3, 1, 2 equals to 0. Okay? Can, huh? So, I cannot rotate this, but imagine how I'm projecting this vector onto this. A project onto this to find this distance. To find this distance. A dot B hat. Okay, A dot B hat. That's why, you see, ta-na-na-na. Okay, this is the A. Okay, so this is the A. So your classmate, I just show that solution. I think it's more powerful if you see. A dot B hat. This is like the B hat. This is like the A. Okay, modulus. Ah, remember the mod. Okay. Remember the mod. Okay? Hey, remember to mod. Okay, remember to mod. Sorry. Let me stress this out, okay? Let me stress this. Remember to mod. Okay, of course, in this case, since it's just nice, it's positive. Okay? That's for the first part. So, this is the perpendicular distance from P to plane 2. Okay? Just by using A dot B hat. Okay, oh. Next one. Okay, question asked for to deduce the perpendicular distance from P to the line of intersection between plane 1 and plane 2. Okay, to the line of intersection between plane 1 and plane 2. This part is not so, this part is a bit tricky. So, you notice you have plane 1. Plane 2. Okay, this one is curved. Now intersection. There's a plane, there's a point here. Okay, so the good way to look at this is to look at it from this direction. Look at it as this angle. Yeah, so that's what I'll do. That's what I'll do. If you don't understand, you must scream, I will say a few times. Oh, I fell before. Very scary. Okay, so deduce the value from P to the line intersection between plane. I look at it from the cross section, children. Okay, the trick here is to look at it from the cross section. This is plane 1. This is plane 2. Is it okay? Okay, where is the line intersection? Can you see the line intersection is here? Okay, can all. So, I want to find, what's the angle between the two of them? 60. Can you see? Or because from part 1, you know that the angle is 60. Okay? Then, from... Wait, am I looking at... Oh, I haven't found this also. Okay. Have I found this? This one, you 3 square root 14 over 2. Okay, so this one, okay, I missed. I didn't really talk about this. Basically, it's just here. Sorry, huh? Okay, let me just talk about this. 3 square root 14 over 2. Okay? So, for part 3, earlier on, you know that the answer is 3 square root 14 over 2. Okay, if I want to find, deduce the perpendicular distance from point P, to the line of intersection between line 1 and line 2. This is the distance that we are looking at. Is it okay? So the key word is, some of you may think, hey, why is it perpendicular? Why is it perpendicular? Yeah, why is it perpendicular? You see, current, So that's why they use the perpendicular distance. But in fact, all they are asking for is they are asking for this. That's all. Okay? Okay, so the trick here is to look at it from a cross-section point of view. Okay, looking at this, right? You know perpendicular distance, this one is 90 degrees. Okay, what do we do? This one just becomes a anyone? Sec 2 E math question. Tuakaso, that's all. You just use a Tuakaso question, that's all. It becomes Tuakaso. So this is opposite, this is hypotenuse. Let's just call this maybe D. Sine 60 degree equals to 3 square root 14 over 2 over D. Okay, and you obtain the D basically is square root 42 units. Okay? Can. So just to show your classmate's answer, that's how we got this part. Okay, you can also use, so you notice that what I use is Tuakaso. Okay, what some of you may use is you may use vector projection. That's fine. Okay, you can see the answer come out the same. This is one way. You can see this one way. Okay, I can show you the two solutions side by side. Okay, okay. Got two ways to do part 3. Okay, this is one way, this is the second way. Method 1, method 2. Okay, I'm actually trying to record this, so y'all will see. Okay, I'm recording. Okay, So next, okay, part 4, given that the Q lies on plane 2, given point Q lies on plane 2, okay, we want to find the length of projection QP onto plane 2. This one, okay, no diagram, so a bit hard to see, but if you, it would be nice to have a diagram, so actually everything I do, I draw a diagram, okay, Yeah. If you don't want to draw, it's fine. Okay. Q lies on plane 2, so Q probably I can put somewhere anywhere you want. Your diagram need not be unique. Okay. Projection of QP. Okay, this concept is important. Okay, projection, all these. Confirm come out one. Projection, reflection. All the things you see there. Okay, onto plane 2. Okay, how to do this? Anything you know about plane 2? What do you know about plane 2? Anything, any information about plane 2?
Ah.
Every time you tell me it's about the plane, first thing I think about is the normal. Every time you talk to me about a line, first thing I think about is the direction. Okay, oh? Correct or not? Correct or not? Okay, huh? Everything is about direction. Everything is about direction. So we look at this line, for example. I know the normal is basically 312 lah. Okay? So how do I find the length of projection of QP onto plane 2? The one we are looking for is this, right? We are just looking for in part 4. Okay, let me stress again. This is PQ10 part 4. In case you daydream, okay, I just okay. Okay, we are looking for this part. Projection of QP onto the plane. Projection of QP onto the plane. We are looking for this part. How to find? Okay, observe carefully. If this is A, if this is B, what is this portion? Vector. Because I don't know what this is. This one is a direction vector. Okay. So think in terms of this is vector A, this is vector B. How do I find this length? Look at it this way. Now nothing? Okay, okay again. If this is A, if this is B, then children, how to find this length? A cross B hat, right? Make sense? A cross B hat? Yeah, okay. So, can you see this portion here is A cross B hat? It's like QP or PQ. I can say it's a PQ. This portion here is PQ cross with N hat. Okay, I just turn like that. Okay. So doesn't mean even though it's like a length of projection, we keep thinking oh A dot B hat. Sometimes it depends on who you have. Always draw, look at the triangle before you deduce whether to use dot product or cross product. Okay? And your vectors one must be very firm. Okay, meaning you can memorize A dot B hat. Yeah? Okay, so with that, I just take basically from here to find the length of projection of PQ onto plane 2 is just PQ cross N hat. Okay? I'll let you work it out by yourself. PQ should be negative 6, negative 3, 0. Cross with N hat 312 over square root 3 square plus 1 square plus 2 square. 54 over 2. Okay? Okay? Children? Okay, then next one would be the last part. Okay, can I go on? Too fast, will you tell me? Too fast, okay. Part 5. Part 5 tells you the fact there's a third plane with this equation that's parallel to plane 1. Okay, a third plane with this equation that's parallel to plane 1. Okay, there's actually, if you look at question 9, right? Something in question 9 will help you. Okay, so plane 3 looks like that. This is my plane 3. Okay, if you remember, children, if from question 9, if I make this normal a unit vector, what do I get here? Still remember? Okay, let me pause a while. You still remember? Okay, I go back to question 9. If R dot N hat equals to, R dot N is equals to D, am I right? Okay, so R dot N hat, is the same as R dot N over the magnitude of N, right? Okay, which is the same as D over the magnitude of N, right? Okay, so actually this is also in your lecture note. Okay, this one is also in your lecture note. Okay, so If you watch the video, there's a 2MA 2J chit chat. I also talk about this. So
okay.
Chit chat video. Because yesterday orientation this year, so only got 5 people come tutorial. So I just talk out with them. I just okay, so I just chit chat with them. Okay, so this is the thing, okay? So then this right basically is the distance from origin to the plane. Okay, this is basically the distance from the origin to the plane. Does it make sense? Doesn't make sense? Okay, never mind. I talk a bit more. Okay, let me show you diagram. Everything I say will only make sense with a diagram. Okay, I have a plane. Okay, I have a point, maybe point A. This point A, again, sorry. O, maybe I use another way. I use point A. Okay, then for the plane, there's a normal vector, right? There's a normal vector, right? Okay, you can see this one. Let's say if I use A, okay, then children, my question is, I look at this happy little triangle and I ask myself, how do I find this length? Can you see it's just A dot N hat? If I want to find the length, can you see it's just A dot N hat? Dion, okay? Okay, Bernice, Mushri, okay. So this one is true, is useful, it's very useful. Okay, really got used before, it's quite useful. It's just A dot N hat, okay? And what is A dot N hat? A dot N hat basically, if we come from the original equation where R dot N equals to A dot N equals to D, right? Then A dot N is just equals to D over N. Okay? Can Is it okay? Okay. So let me stress again, if the... You can actually write your equation in this manner. For equation of a plane, you can write it in this manner lah. Okay? Meaning if the left hand side the normal is a unit vector, right? The right hand side is just the distance between the origin and the plane. Okay? And if you go back to your tutorial, the lecture actually talks about this. Okay? Mm. The lecture actually talks about this. It's quite intuitive. Okay, over here, this is on page 33 of your notes, of vectors 2 notes. This is on page 33 of the vectors 2 notes. Okay, it's quite important. Yeah, is it important? I think important. Okay. You know that plane 1 contains the origin. Okay, do you know anything about this distance? You know that this distance is basically 4 over square root 56. Okay? Can It makes sense? Sorry. Yeah, long. Very, very long. You sleepy, just put the pokey in your mouth. Okay, when you get the tutorial solutions, they also show another method. They use length of projection, but both are fine. Okay, you may have used another method also, which is fine. Okay? Okay, I see your time. Yes. I can simplify. This one basically can be the same as square root 14 over 7. They are the same. Kang Yi? Okay. 4 over square root 56 is the same as 4 square root 4 square root 14. It's the same as 4 over 2 square root 14. It's the same as 2 over square root 14. You just rationalize. Okay. This one you do yourself. Okay. Okay, then okay, let me go to PQ. PQ11, I may not have time. Let me pause for one. I have a habit that I try to do in a scalar product form. This will be like that. Okay, because scalar product form is always the most useful one. I always find scalar product. Okay, everything about the line, the most important thing is the direction. Everything about the plane, the most important thing is the normal. Okay? So from here, so in the question, right, what they say is find the coordinates of any one point common to plane 1 and plane 2, and hence find the intersection. So what they do is, if they didn't say this, right, to find the line of intersection between two planes, how to do? Yes, yeah, good, bagus. Okay, just use the GC. Okay, but in this case, what they do is they want you to find a point. How to find a point? You do it manually. So if I look at these two, right? If I just look at these two, you can let any of them be a fixed number. Okay, so I can choose maybe X to be 0. I can choose Y to be 0. I can choose X to be 0. What I did is, I look at these four. I say, wow, this 4 look very scary. I let the y be 0. So maybe I just say I let y be 0. Y equals to 0. Then what I have is just x minus z equals to 0. 2x plus z equals to negative 12. Okay, and then I solve simultaneously. Okay, what your classmate did is he let x to be a. Actually, a is possible. It is possible. You can still, if you don't want to let it be 0, you want to let it be in some unknown parameter, it's possible. You can still get the answer this way. Okay, this is different. Answer is not unique. Okay, you can have 0, 4, 4. If you look at mine. Oh, my. Okay. 生孩子. Okay. What is this? I let y to be 0. Okay, I let y to be 0. I just solve the same. I just find a point. Legit, go and find a point. Okay? If the question requires it this way, you cannot use a GC. You cannot use a GC. Because the fact is, in the question, they have told you already they want the... Where did my... they want the coordinates. They want the coordinates. Means they want you to find a point and hence. Okay, it's not hence or otherwise. It's hence. Means you really got to find by yourself. Okay, it's hence. Okay? Find the equation of the line intersection of plane 1 and plane 2. Okay? So, given to find the line intersection between plane 1 and plane 2, if I have plane 1, you have almost... Okay, you have one point, then to find the direction vector of the line, all I do is I take the two normals of the plane and I cross product. Okay, I don't know if you can get this part. Okay, but I just take the two normals of the plane and I cross product.
I don't understand why you cannot use GC.
Okay, so here, right, when they talk about the Okay, so if they talk about finding a point, right, means if given the equation of two planes, maybe plane 1, and plane 2, they ask you to find a point, the point that you find to be negative 4, 0, 4. Okay, you cannot use GC. Means when they say hands, right, when they say word hands, means they want you to use the working method. If you use a GC, then you are not answering part 3. You're not answering the whole part 3. Okay, ho. Yeah, so part 3 is cannot be done by using GC. This is how they force the how do I get the direction vector of this line? Yes, cross if this plane here. There's a normal one. This plane here, there's a normal two. Okay, I didn't draw it very well, but this direction vector here
is perpendicular to the first, the two normals. Okay, so I just, to find the direction vector, what I do is I just take N1 cross N2, okay?
Which is what most of y'all would have done. I think y'all would have understood. Oh, I can't find this. Oh. Why? Okay. This app is very good. Okay, I pay. I pay money. Not for. Okay. Huh? Okay. So it's like that. Okay. So basically, you just cross product the two. You just cross product the two. You can get the answer. Okay. 1, 1, 2. Then. Okay. Then I go to quick one. Let me go to part 4. This is for part 3. Is everything okay? Everything okay? We are talking to each other. 眉来眼去. Okay. Okay, part 4. Find the coordinates of the point where the line meets plane 2. This one is, I think it's very straightforward. Okay, so I won't go through. Part 5. Find the perpendicular distance of P from plane 1. Okay, actually all these are quite I think 11 part 4 part 5 is quite straightforward. Okay, so I think you want me to go through it? It's quite okay, let me just show you. I just show you. I won't. First one, find the equation. This is basically nothing. But a question that asks you to find the intersection of line and plane. That's all. Okay? You have the equation of the line. You have the equation of the plane. You solve simultaneously. Okay? Equation of line sub into equation of the plane. So I just basically replace this one as the R. Okay, as the R. Okay, huh? You get your mu equals to 12. The answer is not unique, but the point should be unique. Okay, you should get 3 over 2, 4, comma 1. Okay? So just remember that you're finding a point, not a vector. Okay, you're finding a coordinates of the point. So answer must come out to be 3 over 2, 4, comma 1. Okay, huh? If you didn't get, probably maybe got careless or one. Okay? Next one, find the distance, perpendicular distance from point P from plane 1. So I use a diagram. Okay, 3, 2 from plane 1. This is the distance we are finding. Okay, from plane 1, that's the normal, right? 1, 1, negative 1. Okay, 1, negative 1. I want to find basically this distance. Children, I want to find this distance. Okay, how to find? This one? I just project. Okay, so in any fashion that you like, A dot B hat in order to find your length. I say one more time. A dot B hat. Okay, which is why you can see it here. A dot B hat. Okay, in order to get your length here. Okay? So if all goes well, if you look at the question, right? Question asks to find the perpendicular distance from P to plane 1. If all goes well, your answer should be 3 square root 3. So over here, this length here is 3 square root 3. This is 3 square root 3. Okay? This length here is square root 77. I just take this and this put together. Okay, so if I look at this diagram, the next part is to find the length of projection of OP onto plane 1. The last part of the question is to find this. Okay, can find Pythagoras, this, and this. Okay, Pythagoras, that's all, Pythagoras, okay? So, using Pythagoras theorem. I just use Pythagoras, I find my D2. Okay, I say one more time, in part 5,
they ask us to find this portion first. Okay, this portion first. This portion first. Okay? Then using this I can find my using Pythagoras. But there are a lot of ways. If you went to do A cross B hat, you also get the answer. It's the same.
But what if you hat?
Huh?
Just like
mod is fine. Mod is fine.
Then
what
is it
hat? Which one?
Was it hands
fine? Hands ah, which one?
Cannot.
If you're using hands, that means you must use the earlier one.
So you have put the whole
thing. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, sorry. Because of the word hands. Okay?